Can SoFi stock potentially have a short squeeze in 2023? We talked about this in the SoFi Weekly podcast a couple of days ago with Steven. If you haven't seen that episode, definitely check that out. But basically, the conversation was around when stocks generally reach profitability, the stock price shoots up because the sentiment is renewed in that company, and a lot of analysts jump on board because all of a sudden, the prospects going forward for that company is profitability. I wanted to very quickly hop on and share some thoughts. A lot of these thoughts are very raw. I haven't really dug into a lot of research behind this, but a large part of what spurred this video was the fact that Palantir recently reported earnings earlier tonight, and they reported their first quarter of profitability. And on the earnings call, I was watching it on Amit's live stream, the CEO of Palantir, Alex Karp, also said that this is going to be their first year of profitability, meaning that they are expecting this profitability trend to continue, and from now onwards, for that stock to continue being more and more profitable. And what happened was the stock shot up, right? And after hours, the stock went as high as 20%, 22%, something like that. I mean, we don't know what it's going to end up being tomorrow because CPI report is tomorrow. So obviously, CPI might bring the entire market down, thereby also bringing Palantir down. And we don't know what the trend is going to be a week from now or a month from now based on what Palantir's short interest is and a couple of other metrics for their business. But what we do know is that the stock is up in a big way and everybody is talking about profitability for Palantir. Now, one other thing that sort of reaffirms this thesis that we mentioned in the SoFi Weekly podcast a couple of days ago was the fact that when Tesla reached profitability back in the beginning of 2020, that stock shot up like 4 or 5x. And partially this was due to the fact that Tesla had a huge short interest, which added more and more ammunition to make that ride up even higher. I'm not sure if it was Cathie Wood who said this or someone else, but basically the quote was something along the lines of, the longer a stock trades sideways, the higher the move up is going to be when they eventually break out of their norm. And so, okay, let's bring this back. We know that Tesla had a huge short squeeze because it was a highly shorted stock and they went profitable. And so the sentiment changed around that play. Recently, now Palantir has also gone profitable. So we're going to see how it performs over the next week and month. Of course, if it goes negative, all of this stuff that I'm saying will get negated somehow. But I believe that it's going to turn around now that it is trending profitably because of these analysts. And finally, we also know that profitability is coming for SoFi. Management laid that out. It was one of their biggest selling points in the Q4 earnings call. They said that this year, they are going to reach profitability. So similarly to Palantir, they're going to have a profitable quarter. Everybody is expecting Q4 because that's what Anthony Noto said. I'm expecting Q3 because the loan business is going to do well. Personal loans is still going to piggyback student loans and home loans. The tech business, the margins were quite low this quarter around, but management in the earnings call highlighted that they expect significant margin expansion this year. And in addition to that, they also said that they expect financial services to also be profitable. This is their only unprofitable segment as it stands. So if all three segments of their business are profitable, then they're going to reach that profitability sooner rather than later. So talking about a short squeeze, I think it really depends on three main factors. Number one is the short interest. We know that SoFi short interest hovers around the mid-teens. It fluctuates pretty rapidly. I think it's been as high as 25 to 30% way back, but we know that it's higher than 10%. It's one of the more shorted stocks out there. Of course, this is not as high as Tesla short interest was back in the day. Tesla had something like 30 to 40% short interest, which again, more gunpowder for that move up. So the short interest will be a key factor to determine whether we have a short squeeze or not. The second key factor is going to be market sentiment. Basically, if we're out of this storm from a macro perspective by Q3, and if the market sentiment is positive, everybody thinks we're going back to a bull market and expectations are high, we're more leaning on the greed side than we are on the fear aspect. That is also a positive for SoFi to have a short squeeze because we're reaching that euphoria in the market. Now, we don't know necessarily what that market sentiment is going to be, but I think around Q3, or especially around Q4, we will have been through the most difficult period with regards to that recessionary expectation. Remember, the market is about 6 to 9 months in advance of what the economy is. And so the economy could very well be in a recession in 9 months, but the market will have priced that in and moved forward from there. And the third aspect of whether we could or could not have a short squeeze, I think is really going to depend on the internal sentiment of what the management team is saying. So basically, they're going to have that earnings report where they report a positive EPS number. What is the management going to say on the call? What is their forward guidance going from there? What is that expectation? And I think a lot of it is going to come down in the hands of management. That also gives us more insight as to what we can expect in 2024 for SoFi. For example, Alex Karp in this call, he said, we can expect full year profitability for Palantir this year. And so analysts now in the back of their mind, they can model that into their pricing, and a lot of people can now start to expect Palantir to be fully profitable for the rest of the year. So those are the three factors: short interest, macro, and micro sentiment that's coming from management. When do I think this will happen? As I mentioned, I think Q3 is going to be the first positive EPS quarter for SoFi. Anthony Noro said Q4, but SoFi has a vast history of under-promising and over-delivering on a lot of their expectations. I've been DCAing into SoFi for the past 2 years, ever since they became a public company. Everything in this video doesn't really matter if you're a long-term holder of SoFi, because you're going to hold it regardless of whether we do or don't have a short squeeze. Profitability is a huge fundamental aspect of business health, regardless of what the stock price does in the short term. So safe to say, I'm going to continue to DCA in regardless of what happens. But again, as I mentioned, these are just my raw thoughts in the moment after digesting Palantir's earnings a little bit and hopping off of that earnings call for Palantir, where they were talking a lot about profitability. I was framing that more and more as a model for what we can expect for SoFi going forward. Obviously not an apples to apples comparison, but still interesting to see another company reporting profitability and shooting up 20% in the after hours. And if CPI comes in positive tomorrow, I think the rest of the market will also be green. Of course, it goes without saying that I'm pretty excited for SoFi in 2023. This is going to be a breakout year for them from a company perspective, but also potentially from a stock perspective. If you enjoyed this video, subscribe to the channel for more. For right now, this is the Fundamentals Investing Podcast. Thank you so much for listening.